What's going on, guys? Skateman87 here, back with another video. Today a little bit of a different one. We're going to do a short tutorial on Reshade, how to get it, how to install it, and how to set it up. Hopefully after watching this video you realize how easy it is just to install and set up, and the difference that it makes. Not only change the way you see the game, but the way you feel and play it as well. So without wasting too much time, let's get into it. So first things first, we're going to go ahead to the Reshade website. I've included a link in the description, so you can just follow along there if you'd like, or you can just type it into your browser, reshade.me. Once there, you're going to see this download. You're going to click on it, and it's going to bring us down here to our latest version, where we're going to click download here, which we've done here, and we're going to go ahead and open it up. Once we've opened it up, you'll see it populate a list of our kind of commonly played games. If we go down the list here, we'll see a bunch of different games. Now for this DCS file here, this is probably going to be pre-multi-threading, because that was released just this past Friday. So if you haven't run Reshade before and it sees DCS, it's going to be the pre-multi-threaded version. So if we're running the new multi-threaded version, which I highly recommend, it's absolutely stunning. It almost looks real. We have to find where that is because it's a different file and it's a different path. So we're going to go ahead and we're going to go to Browse. And I play on Steam, so mine's going to be in the Steam location. For those that play on the standalone, I'm not exactly sure where it is, but it's just going to be a different spot. So for us on Steam, we're going to go to Program Files, Steam, Steam Apps, Common, DCS World. Now, Bin is where you would get it if you're not playing on the multi-thread version. So this is the original DCS version here. But for us on the multi-thread, we're now going to go into Bin MT or Bin Multi-Threading. That up, and we'll see the DCS EXE here. We'll double click on that. We can see that it opens it up, Program Files, Steam, Steam Apps, Common, DCS World, Bin MT for multi-threading, and the file. Go ahead and click Next. For our rendering, we're going to set Microsoft DirectX 10, 11, and 12. I do not have a preset because I uninstalled this for the sake of this video, so we're going to go ahead and click Next. I do not make any changes in here, so I click Next. This is our effects. Again, I do not make any changes in here, but this is the effects that we are actually inserting into Reshade. So again, I click Next, and that's it. Successfully installed Reshade. Click Finish button to exit the setup tool. So we click Finished, and the next setup is just to open up DCS World. Okay, so we've gone ahead and loaded up DCS. You can see in the top left here that the Reshade has it's telling us that it is now installed successfully. Press the Home key to start the tutorial. So we're going to go ahead and we're going to press the home key. And it's going to greet us with this. For the sake of this video, I skipped the tutorial. But it's totally up to you if you want to go ahead and go through it. It's never a bad thing to run yourself through tutorials. But we're going to go ahead and we're going to skip it. We're going to be greeted with this effects menu here. But the first step is probably the most important step. Giving yourself a reference. Giving yourself a baseline of sorts. The reason for that is you can get a little bit ahead of yourself, start making a lot of changes in here, and kind of go, oh, I don't know where I started from. I don't know what it looked like before. And that can just be a big problem. So we go up here and we go into settings. And you can see here we got an overlay key, which is what brings this menu up. And we've got the effect toggle key. So you can make these whatever you want. So if you want your overlay key, like this menu, to be insert, you know, you just click in it there, and then you just click the key that you want it. I like it being home, just what I've been using, so I'm going to go back and make it home. The effect toggle key, for me, I use end, but like I said, you guys can use literally any key on the keyboard that you like, but I like using end. After you've made these two adjustments, these two keys, come back to home, and again, here's our effects page. I only use four effects. Two main effects, and I've been dabbling with two as of late. I've been dabbling with color matrix and vibrance. But the two main ones that I do use are curves and Luma Sharpen. Big shout out to Bogey Dope. He had a great video a year ago kind of going over this, and it just made my experience so much better. So huge shout out to him just with the multi-threading update and just trying to shorten the video. We're going ahead and we're releasing another one. So gonna click on curves, and you can see just clicking on that already, like, the difference it's made in the image behind. My settings that I use is 0.75 for the contrast. So you just grab the slider and kind of move it wherever you like. So I'll try to get it close, 0.748, and then we can use these to do it by one. So down, up, 0.75. So we got our curves, and you know, we can unclick it like this, or I am hitting the end button here, and you can see that off, on, off, on. Go ahead to our Luma Sharpen. My sharpening strength, I like to have at 2. Not a huge difference, but ultimately you can just see the definition is a lot sharper when you set it up to 2, which I prefer. So go ahead and we set that to 2. My sharpening limit, I set to 0.05. So bring that down to here. 0.56. Oops. 0.51. Okay, that one's a little bit. We'll keep it there. One off. Offset bias is 1. I don't ever touch that. So I'm going to hit the home key here to bring the menu down. And just with those two settings alone, that's on. That's off. It's on. Off. I just feel like an optometrist, but I mean, I'm pretty sure you can tell the difference. And then, like I said, I've been dabbling here with color matrix and vibrance as of late, and I mean, yeah, it's just something else entirely. We'll go ahead and we'll go in game to see the difference in game, but I mean, already I think you can tell that it's just gonna everything. Cockpit textures, terrains, clouds, the immersion, the feel, the look. It's just a step above. So we're back in game here now. Let's see, this is Richet turned on. The deck. We're on the USS Theodore Roosevelt here. Catapult launch. That is the base game. That is Reshade. Now the thing that I like about this is we're going to go ahead and press home, bring up the menu, kind of play with it on the fly. So, you know, if you don't like the color matrix, go ahead and shut it off, turn it on. Right, and that's the thing that's cool about this. So you can kind of really do anything on the fly, you know, dabble with certain settings, kind of take a look at it, you know. Maybe I don't want color matrix on here. Maybe I think it looks better like this. But pressing the effects key, this is the base. And that's Reshade. So, in my opinion, it definitely adds another element to the game. Just makes it visually stunning, in my opinion. That's it for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed. If you have any questions, feel free to leave a comment. I'll answer any questions, try to answer any questions you guys have. But with all that being said, I hope you enjoyed this video. Don't be afraid to smash that like and subscribe button. Alright everyone, you have yourself a great day.